In a bruising day of evidence, the House Democrats built a compelling case against the former president. First, how Trump incited his base to riot on January 6th.
Over many months, Donald Trump cultivated violence.
He made sweeping allegations about election fraud that couldn't possibly be true. He wanted to make sure that his supporters were angry.
He said, "We're going to the Capitol.
We're
going to
walk down.
And we fight.
And if you don't fight like hell, you're not going to have a country anymore.
There was harrowing testimony.
I stood with colleagues in the gallery above the House floor. Someone shouted up to us, "Duck, lie down, then ready your gas masks." Shortly after, there was a terrifying banging on the chamber doors. I will never forget that sound.
They presented chilling, previously unseen video of the siege. Body cam footage showing police officers beaten, kicked and tasered. Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer seen fleeing down a corridor, while hero officer Eugene Goodman, one of the first to confront the invading mob, frantically diverts Senator Mitt Romney away from the baying crowd.
Officer Goodman directs him to turn around to get to safety.
Senate members, now in gas masks, evacuated from the chamber.
They walk just feet away from where Capitol Police are holding an insurrectionist at gunpoint.
And Mike Pence escaping to safety.
They heard rioters say they were looking for Pence in order to execute him.
The rioters scoured the building for House Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
Nancy, where are you, Nancy? We're looking for you.
As her petrified staffers made whispered calls for help.
We need Capitol Police, I think. Got another one. They're pounding the doors trying to find her.
The nation's top lawmakers, once again, shaken to their core.
The evidence presented is pretty damning.
It was gut-wrenching. It was compelling.
But will it persuade enough Republicans to cross the floor and convict Donald Trump?
Because the truth is, this attack never would have happened but for Donald Trump.
Norman Ornstein is contributing editor for The Atlantic and joins us now from Washington, D.C. Norman, so we heard Democrat senators, but not just them, Republican senators also seem to have been quite shaken by what they've seen today. Do you think this will change any Republican minds, though?
So, to quote James Bond, they were shaken but not stirred.
Right.
I'm afraid not enough of them are looking to change the way they started this process. And right now, after what was an extraordinary and compelling story, that, you know, it was clear that Donald Trump was the link that incited this riot, you still get these excuses coming from key Republicans. You know, one of them, James Lankford of Oklahoma, who really did come close to being captured and probably killed, was so shaken that his colleagues had to comfort him. But I think the odds that Lankford will now vote to convict Trump are still very small. Unless you see Republicans in the country, large numbers of them, turn against Trump and recognize what he's done, these senators are not going to be stirred to change.
If that's right, that means that Trump, there's no real prospect of Trump being convicted. Would you believe that there is any point to the process, given that foregone conclusion?
Oh. No, there's a very big point to this process. And it starts with the reality that most Americans saw a little bit of what was going on, but did not get the depth of the threat here. So now people are not only seeing it, and seeing it in many cases for the first time, but with a narrative that shows how Trump was the one who incited this. And at the same time, one of the arguments used by some of the Republicans is the appropriate venue for this is in the criminal courts. This may actually be the avenue to get some criminal action taken against him. I think it may build some momentum that at least is going to scar Trump the way he should be scarred in history and for the rest of his life.
It's been suggested that if they fail to convict, they could still censure Trump. What does this mean, Norman, and is it painful?
Under normal circumstances, a censure is a very humiliating and painful thing. It wouldn't be so much for Trump. But the kicker here is that if the impeachment conviction fails, after that, the 14th Amendment of our Constitution says that anybody who tries to commit sedition or insurrection against the government can be barred for life from holding any other office of the United States. That only requires a majority vote. And I suspect that in the end, they'll be able to block Trump from being able to run for president again. You know, having been impeached twice and censured once is still going to mark him in history.
We're definitely watching history, Norman. We'll see what's yet to be written. Thank you very much for speaking to us tonight.
Lot to go.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.